Hello and welcome to DCBA. Here we have to find the rotation at C using Castiglione's method. In all our earlier problems, we had found only the deflection, horizontal or vertical deflection, but we have not yet solved a problem using the rotations. So let us find the rotation at C. What is the load which is causing the rotation? The load causing a rotation is equal to m kilonewton meter. This is because this is the only load which is acting, so it is very obvious. Second, Castigliano's imaginary moment again, I'll name it as p itself, and I'll assume that it is acting in the same direction, that is clockwise direction P. Okay, so together it will be not M, it will be M plus P. Okay, M plus P kilonewton meter. Third is finding the reactions now. So we have a vertical reaction here VA and a horizontal reaction HA. Your BD and HD. So now basically what we'll do is that since we are given here with an internal hinge, we'll separate it at the internal hinge, and then we'll solve it for the BA and HA, BD and HD. Here let us say this as a VB and HB, and whatever reactions here we'll have to write opposite to them. So if your VB is downwards, your VB will be upwards, your HB left, so your it will be to the right. So basically you're free to start with any of the either of the frames. I start with this frame, so let's say summation fx equal to 0, hb is equal to hd, summation fy equal to 0. So I'll get vb is equal to vd, and then summation mb equal to 0. I'll get vd into 2 plus HD into 2 minus of M plus P is equal to 0. So if I simplify this equation, I'll get 2VD plus 2HD is equal to M plus P. Okay. Now let us move on here because we cannot solve it any further. We'll see what we get from this side. Summation fx equal to 0, ha is equal to hb, and I can write it as equal to hd as well from this equation or from this reference. Then summation fy equal to 0, I can write va plus vb is equal to 0, and then summation ma equal to 0, I can write it as VB into 4 is equal to HB into 3. Okay, VB into 4 is equal to HB into 3. But I'll basically replace this VB with VD, because VB is equal to VD, we have already found from this reference. And again, I'll separate this, I'll replace this HB with HD. So what do I get here? VD into 4 minus 3HD is equal to 0. So I've got this equation as well, and I have this equation also. You need to solve them simultaneously to get the answer of VT and HT. So how will you solve them now simultaneously? Basically, you can solve them by the method of elimination. That is, you need to eliminate either of the variables, that is VD. Either you eliminate VD or you eliminate HD. How will you eliminate HD? Here it is 3HD, here it is 2HD. We can find a common multiple of 3 and 2. Let's say it is 6. So we'll have to multiply this equation by 2. And what do we get here? 2 into 4 is 8 VD minus 6HD is equal to 0. And we'll multiply this equation by 3. So 6VD plus 6HD is equal to 3 times M plus B. And now what will happen when you add both these equations? This HD and HD will get cancelled, isn't it? So I'll add it here itself. Let's say 6VD plus 6HD is equal to 3 times M plus B. And when you add it up, this HD gets cancelled. You are left with 14VD is equal to 3 times M plus B. Therefore, VD is equal to 3 by 14 of M plus B. So we have this equation here. VD is 3 by 14 of M plus B. Similarly, you can find all other variables from VD. From VD, I can say VB is also equal to 3 by 14. So this is equal to VB. Right, VB is also equal to 3 by 14. What do we have here? VA is equal to minus of VB. So VA will be equal to minus of 3 by 14 M plus B, which is equal to 3 by 14 M plus B, but acting downwards. Since here we had shown it acting upwards, and we got it as negative, so it will be 3 by 14 M plus B acting downwards. Then what else do we have? HA and HB. Yeah, so we have found VD. We can substitute VD in either of these equations and we can find HD. And HA, HB, HD all will be same. So HA equal to HB equal to HD is equal to 2 by 7 of M plus B. You can find it by substitution. And what are we left now with? We have basically found out all the parameters, right? So VD, VB, HB, VA and HA. Now we are good to find MX equations. So first I'll just write here all the reactions that we have found. So VA was 3 by 14 M plus B downwards. HA is equal to 2 by 7 M plus B. Then this is equal to 3 by 14 M plus B. This is equal to 2 by 7 M plus B. Again here it will be 2 by 7 M plus B downwards of 3 by 14 M plus B. Here it will be 3 by 14 M plus B. 2 by 7 M plus B. And here the moment will be equal to M plus B. Okay. Now we'll find MX equations. Let us take like this, a section like this, where X is starting from A and it is going like this. Okay. This part is Y, and we had already seen how to find, how to express Y in terms of X. So your Y by X is equal to 3 by 4, therefore Y is equal to 3 by 4 X from this triangle.
and mx here I'll get mx is equal to two by seven m plus p into y. I'll just write it directly as 3 by 4x minus 3 by 14 m plus p into x. Okay, this is the mx equation for AB. For BC, we take a section like this, x. So for BC, mx will be equal to minus of 3 by 14 m plus p into x. For a member DC, let us take a section like this, x going upwards starting from D, and mx will be equal to 2 by 7 m plus p into x. 2 by 7 m plus p into x.
Again, we'll tabulate our calculations. So for AB, the origin was A and the limits for AB. Now x is horizontal, right? So to traverse this AB, it has to travel horizontally from 0 to 4. So the limits are 0 to 4. 0 to 4. Mx equation was 2 by 7 of m plus p
into 3 by 4x minus 3 by 14 of m plus p into x. So the dou mx by dou p will be equal to 3 by 14 of x minus 3 by 14 of x, which is equal to 0. Okay, and your ei is ei, and theta due to ab, theta due to ab is equal to 0 since this term itself is 0, so there is no point in solving it further, which is actually correct because ab is not going to contribute anything to the rotation at C since there is a hinge here. Okay, and no moment is transmitted from a hinge point, so even if this was to deflect in any way, the moment could not be transferred to this part because there is a hinge here. Then we have BC. I'll simply write it on another page. BC with the origin B, the limits to be 0 to 2, and mx is equal to minus of 3 by 14 m plus p into x, and here it is minus 3 by 14 x if you differentiate it partially. Then theta bc will be equal to 0 to 2, and I'll just write it directly here, 3 by 14 square x, 3 by 14 x the whole square into m plus p dx. So this p can be erased out, and you are left with m upon ei integration of 0 to 2, 3 by 14 x the whole square dx. And once you solve it, you will get it as equal to 6 by 49 m upon ei.
So this is the contribution due to BC,
and then there will be contribution due to CD, the last member CD, and the origin for this is D, the limits are 0 to 2, and mx equation is 2 by 7 x m plus p, and dou mx by dou p is 2 by 7 x. EI theta CD is equal to 0 to 2, and again here I'll write 2 by 7 x the whole square into m plus p dx upon EI. So p can be cancelled out again. Here we are left with m upon EI integration of 0 to 2, 2 by 7 x the whole square into dx. Alright, and once you solve this, you will get it as equal to 32 m upon 147 EI. Okay.
So total theta due to AB, BC and CD. I'll just write here AB, BC and CD. So due to AB it was 0.
Due to BC it was 6 m upon 49 EI. Due to CD it is 32 m upon 147 EI. And when you calculate it, when you sum it up, you will get theta is equal to 50 upon 147 m by EI radians.
And this solves or this completes your entire problem.